Hi, I'm Ron Jordan with Focus on Energy, and we are standing in this lot with Jackie and Kevin, and they are going to be building a house. We are going to help them build a house, and it is a net zero energy home. How are you guys doing?
We're doing great. Very exciting times for us.
Good. So tell everyone, what exactly is a net zero energy home?
Well, I want to be clear, what we're building isn't a net zero energy home yet. It will be when we put on the solar panels and offset our annual energy usage. So for now, we're calling it a net zero energy ready house.
Okay. All right. That's fine. So why? I guess if the solar panels are going to be what offsets the energy, why not just build a regular home and then put the panels on it, and then there you go?
You know, we've talked a lot about the why, and you know, there's definitely an economic piece of this. Like, we think it would be pretty cool to generate enough of our own solar energy to operate our house. Right, Kevin?
Yeah, and better for comfort and allergies as well.
Yeah, for the allergy sufferers in the house.
Yeah, indoor air quality, and I get it. I'm an allergy sufferer.
Yeah, and you know, I think the other part of it is it feels good. I mean, it's a small thing to protect the environment. There's a lot of things you can do to make your house sustainable that we're not doing. We're really honed in on the energy side of things, and we're proud to be able to do that.
And not to mention, this entire development was built with energy efficiency in mind.
Oh my gosh, yeah. The developer is doing so many things that aligns with our philosophy for sure. There's going to be a car sharing program. There's going to be some community gardens right over there for us to use. There's a bike path that goes all the way around the neighborhood and eventually will connect to the Capital City State Trail, which we love. They've thought of rainwater, so there'll be water infiltration and some runoff designs.
There's an energy efficient school neighborhood as well.
That's right.
Oh, that's right. The only one in Wisconsin.
Yeah, and things will be really walkable. There'll be a town square, some retail for us to get to. So we're really excited about this. Yeah.
So obviously this is more than just slapping on some solar panels.
Oh yeah. I mean, there are so many technologies out there that you can put into your house to make it use less energy. We're doing some of those here. And remember, our goal is to make the house use as little energy as possible so that we can be net zero once we put those solar panels on.
So what are you actually building here? How big is the house going to be?
So the house will be two stories. The finished part of it will be 2,300 square feet. We'll have open concept in the kitchen, in the first floor. So we'll have the kitchen, the living room, you know, some typical things you see in a house, a pantry, a foyer, bathroom. We'll also have an office on the first floor. And then the second floor will have four bedrooms, two bathrooms, and laundry.
So when is work going to begin here? It's May right now.
Work begins in 2 weeks, and I think we're hoping to move in. I think October would be great.
That's a quick build.
Yeah, it's pretty fast.
So, big question, who can build this kind of home? What's the cost? And I guess this is where Focus on Energy comes in.
Yeah, exactly. Focus on Energy has been a big help. Our builders working with Focus on Energy to make this a Focus on Energy certified new home, which means it's going to be more efficient than the standard home that's built, and also that our builder knows how to do it, partially because of the help they've been getting from Focus on Energy.
So who is helping you with this project with Focus on Energy?
Our builder is working with a building performance consultant that's provided through that Focus on Energy program. They're a huge help. They're doing an energy model on our house, and they're also going to be conducting a few tests of the house. In addition, they'll be conducting site visits and checking out our house as it's being built to make sure all those energy efficient components are built as we want them to be built.
All right, let's get down to the nitty gritty. When are you going to stop seeing energy bills?
It's not exactly how it works, Ron. We will still have energy bills, but you know, there's different ways of defining net zero energy homes. And for us, what it means is offsetting the annual energy use of our house with the annual production of our solar panels.
All right, so what are you putting in the house then that makes it more energy efficient?
Yeah, good question. There's a lot of things. We're upgrading all the appliances to be Energy Star certified appliances. Obviously, we'll be putting LEDs throughout the house. Not energy energy efficient, but in the spirit of conservation, we're putting low flow toilets and fixtures as well in the house.
All right, and what about HVAC?
Oh, we're installing an ASHP.
Okay. No acronyms. People don't know what that is.
Okay. That's fair. It's a cold climate, I can specify, cold climate air source heat pump, which has been a little bit of a design process with the builder and HVAC contractor, but we're feeling really good about it right now.
So these are pretty new. You feel comfortable with it, Kevin?
Yeah, I do. I think after learning about the technology, I feel comfortable with it.
Yeah, and I mean, the air source heat pump might not save us money in the short run because it runs on electricity, and electricity costs more than gas. But the idea is that we're taking the load, reducing the load of our house by making it more energy efficient. So the system will operate more efficiently. Once we put the solar panels on, we'll be that much closer to our net zero energy goal.
Yeah, and Focus on Energy offers incentives for air source heat pumps, and we're eligible.
Fantastic.
Again, the money guy.
The money guy. What about insulation?
We're opting for higher R values throughout the house, so in the attic, on the exterior walls, and the foundation of the basement. The higher the R value, the better. What it means is our house will be better at keeping hot and cold air from sneaking in and out of the house.
And what about the solar panels? Where are they
going
to be?
The solar panels are going right there. We're not far away from them. I haven't specced out the size yet. I have to do that, I know. But there's a few things we've done already to think about solar panels and the design. So we've reoriented the roof to face south. We changed the pitch of our roof to optimize the solar gain. And our builder has a part of our drawings specced out for where the solar panel installation will go. So there won't be any vents. They'll make sure there's conduit running down to the basement. We'll be all set once we are ready to put the solar panels on.
Yeah, the other things we're doing are the heat pump water heater, an ERV, electric vehicle charger.
Yep.
As well as the builder is already putting in higher low E value.
Yeah, I know. It's a lot for you. Yeah. We're putting in low E windows. Well, rather, the builder's already been putting those in, and they've already considered a lot in the design of the building to make it more energy efficient. So there's a lot of things we didn't even have to worry about.
Thank you both for taking us on this journey. It's going to be a fantastic project. We're really excited about it. Should probably call this Friday Focus 10, because I'm sure this is longer than 5 minutes. Thanks for joining us. We're going to check back with them in a month and see how everything is going around here. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in a month.